But besides that, welcome to my channel. My name is Boski and I am learning the violin. In my first lesson with my teacher, I learned about my new violin. It is brand new, never been used. So that being said, the bow doesn't have any rosin on it. You need rosin on a bow so that it can grip the bow string and get a lovely sound out of it. So no rosin means no grip. No grip means no sound. So the thing about first-time bows is it takes a little bit to get a nice coat of rosin on it. I also found out the hard way that if you, say, tap this little metal part at the bottom of your bow with the rosin while you're going over, your rosin will then, as you can see here, it will crack. Those little yellow dots are cracks in my rosin. I also learned that rosin, especially brand new rosin, has a nice, you see it's really shiny coating on it. Shiny coating means it won't go on the bow. What you can do is you can just start off and do it a little extra longer in the beginning. Once the shiny coat's gone, you're fine. Or you can take a fine grit sandpaper and just pass it over two or three times. You don't need much, just enough to get the shiny coating off. So what you want to do with your bow, so you don't crack your rosin by tapping it on the metal, is take your bow, take your thumb, and gently put it over the metal so that it cannot hit. So that when your rosin comes down, it just taps against your thumb, like so, and doesn't crack. Because you want to put a lot of pressure, not do it gently and softly and delicately, but just a lot of pressure, not too much that you're going to bend your bow, but just a lot of pressure when you're doing it. Another thing is you want your bow to be tightened, not loose, so about between top and bottom about an inch. You also never want to touch the hairs of your bow with your fingers. There's oils on your fingers that once it touches the rosin, makes the rosin go all gooey and gross, and you just don't get a nice sound of your violin. Your bow becomes all sorts of growth, and it's just a pain. Another thing is, as I learned, you don't want to do the whole bow at once, non-stop. It'll take you a long time to get the first coating on. What you want to do is start about 6 inches. Just take your bow, work the rosin up about 6 inches, to keep doing it for about a minute the first time per 6 inches. Once you have a nice coating of rosin on your bow, it'll be like a nice white powder almost on your 6 inches. You just then go from your 6 inches and go up another 6 inches. Do the same thing for about a minute or two, depending on how much pressure you're using and if you have the coating on or not. And just keep doing it until you get all the way to the end. So you want to stop about here. You'll see it goes right onto the tip, I think. So you get right to the end with the whole coating. That's just for the first time. Next time you just literally have to do a quick 20 seconds all the way up. You're good to go. Some people like a lot of rosin on their bow. Some people don't. I'm not sure yet. I'm probably just going to rosin it every time when I pull it out. Do a quick rosin, get my bow out, test it. You'll know if you have enough rosin on it if you can get a sound out of your violin. If there isn't enough rosin, you won't get a nice sound or sound at all. So you just put the rosin on, and if you think you're done, you pull out your violin, give it a go, you get no sound, just go back at it. Again, you only have to do this the first time. After that, it's just a quick top up. But that's it. Rosin also lasts a long time, so if it's not going down and you think you're not using enough, that's okay. Again, this piece of rosin should last a year, if not two, and it won't even be gone. It'll just have a nice dent in it, and we'll just need to replace, because if I keep going, it'll crack through. You can then take the half and keep going, depending on if you're stickler for clean or if you're willing to do the little pieces up. Rosin comes in a couple different forms. I've seen it in like a matchbox almost, it's square, where you just put it on, use the box. Also, mine comes in this tin, got it from my local place. It's only like $5, if not a little bit more. $5 Canadian. I am Canadian, but probably even cheaper in the States. It should last you a good long while. Some people say just replace it every year to be safe, or as needed, depending. If you're a student, I would suggest replacing it every year just until you're comfortable with knowing about it. I've seen people use it for a year, one direction, get a nice indent in it, the shape of the bowstring, and then they just flip it, and then they go the opposite direction and end up with a cross or an X. I've seen some people use it all the way through, crack it in half, and then take those halves and use the half and turn it into a crescent moon. There are different options, but again, that's all you have to do. But this is my channel, and I hope you enjoyed it.